All vertebrates other than fish that have ever existed have four limbs or fewer. This holds true across the vast diversity of animals throughout the history of life on Earth. This group of vertebrates that includes amphibians, reptiles, birds, by extension dinosaurs, and mammals, including humans, is called tetrapods, literally 4 foot. But what is the origin of this four-limbed build? How did vertebrates first evolve feet? What ecological pressures designed it? Well, the answers have been revealed by this meme fish thing, the Tiktaalik. Over 375 million years ago, Earth was a world dominated by oceans and primitive plant-covered landscapes. This was the Devonian period, often called the Age of Fishes, as most animals still live underwater. Only arthropods have ventured far into the dry land, and in this period, lived a fish with unusually robust bony fins, named the Tiktaalik. It would fit neatly between earlier lobe-finned fish such as Eustonopteron and early tetrapods such as Ichthyostega, as it exhibits traits as an intermediate form from swimming fish to four-legged vertebrates. Tiktaalik was discovered in 2004 in Ellesmere Island, Nunavut, in northern Canada. The name is an Inuktitut word meaning large freshwater fish, a local language from the fossil area. Talking about fish, I want to share something with you. An immersive fishing experience right in your pocket. Fishing Clash, the sponsor of this video. Here you can discover hundreds of unique fish species beautifully designed to encapsulate a realistic fishing experience, from giant monster fish to elusive exotic species in over 50 unique fisheries, all waiting to be explored. Fishing Clash offers stunning visuals, whether the thrills of reeling in a rare fish or simply enjoying the serene scenery. The graphics and sound designs will not disappoint. And it's not just about fishing. You can upgrade your gear, collect the ultimate trophy fish, and compete with other players in tournaments. You can download the game using my link in the description or scan the QR code on screen. By downloading the game and using my special gift code Factor, you are supporting this channel. To claim a $20 value reward, enter the code Factor and receive a special welcome bonus, including a unique avatar for free. Download Fishing Clash today. To understand the significance of Tiktaalik, we need to go back to its predecessors, the lobe-finned fish. Unlike most fishes alive today that are ray-finned with thin bony spines, lobe-finned fishes have robust, fleshy fins supported by bones. It's these slim bones, among other features, that allowed lobe-finned fish to be more amphibious than its ray-finned cousins. Some, like the Eustonopteron, are thought to have been able to push themselves along shallow waters. And Tiktaalik took these adaptations and made them its entire personality. It had scales, gills, and fins like a fish, but it also had traits that were remarkably tetrapod-like. A neck, it lacked gill-covering bones, which allowed it to move its head independently. Semi-rigid overlapping ribs to support its body in shallow water or on land. And most intriguingly, fins with bones resembling a primitive wrist and fingers. The forelimbs or pectoral fins were clearly weight-bearing. They were attached to massive shoulder girdles with mobile joints and strong muscles. Its hind limbs or pelvic fins were about the same size as the forelimbs and would have had similar structure. These fins were strong enough to support Tiktaalik's weight in the shallows, allowing it to push itself up and perhaps even venture onto land. And it's these four bony fins that gave rise to the limbs all terrestrial vertebrates rely on for survival for the hundreds of millions of years onwards. This is the same tetrapodal body plan blueprint employed by the last common ancestor from which all amphibians, reptiles, birds, and mammals descended from. Therefore, all of them have a four-limbed body plan or less. But why leave the water at all? It's been thought that the Devonian period saw a decline in oxygen levels, and since oxygen concentration in water is always lower than in the air, this pushed the ancient fish to breathe air. Yes, Tiktaalik and its more ancient relatives like Eustonopteron could breathe air, indicated by the possible presence of primitive lungs. Tough competition in shallow waters also made moving to land, even temporarily, a big advantage. The land offered shelter from predators and food. Tiktaalik was a predator, and Devonian land-dwelling invertebrates would have been in its menu. Tiktaalik's discovery fills a critical gap in the fossil record, showing us how the transition from water to land likely occurred. It's part of a broader narrative of tetrapod evolution that includes other transitional fossils like Acanthostega and Ichthyostega, which had more developed limbs but were still tied to aquatic environments. And although Tiktaalik has never been claimed as the direct ancestor of modern tetrapods, its fossils help to illuminate evolutionary trends and approximate the hypothetical true ancestor to the tetrapod lineage, which would have been similar in form and ecology. However, a complicating discovery was made in the Holy Cross Mountains of Poland, a series of trackways, footprints from the Middle Devonian, between 390 and 391 million years ago, over 15 million years older than the Tiktaalik. These trackways appear to have been created by terrestrial tetrapods with a quadrupedal gait. If the Zahelmia trackways are true, and not fish nests or feeding traces, as interpreted by some workers, then the trackmakers would have been large creatures over 2.5 meters long, more advanced than Ichthyostega in quadrupedalism, and would suggest that digited tetrapods may have appeared as early as around 400 million years ago, way earlier than any known fossil evidence. The implications of this find has led to several different perspectives on the sequence of events involved in tetrapod evolution. One hypothesis to resolve this discrepancy is that the nearest common ancestor of the trackmaker and Tiktaalik dates to the early Devonian. The lineage is the closest to tetrapods, but Tiktaalik itself was a late surviving relic. Another hypothesis is that Tiktaalik and the Zahelmia trackmakers were a result of convergent or parallel evolution. This would indicate that many of the traits and striking anatomical similarities found in both digit-bearing tetrapods and elpistostegalians evolved at least twice, potentially for the same ecological utility. These fossils remind us that evolution is not a sudden leap, but a series of gradual changes with no end goal in mind, driven by challenges and opportunities. Whatever traits allowed a population to survive will be passed on to and reinforced in the next generation. Today, tetrapods dominate terrestrial ecosystems, but we owe our existence to ancient pioneers like Tiktaalik. This humble fisherpod bridged two worlds, laying the foundation for one of the greatest evolutionary transformations in Earth's history, one that revolutionized vertebrate life on this planet. Don't forget to check out Fishing Clash. Click the link in the description or scan the QR code on screen to download the game.